it's Breyonna. So today we're going to be testing out the brand new Wet n Wild Lilo & Stitch collab, which, oh my gosh, like, I love Lilo & Stitch. It was one of my favorite, like, movies kind of growing up. Like, when I was older, I really enjoyed it. I thought it was really funny, and I loved the TV show as well. But, I mean, we are going to be trying the whole shebang shaboom today, and let's just say we got a lot of things to try, so grab yourself a snack, a drink, something, because we got a lot of things to talk about. So I just primed my eyes using my ABH eye primer, but, like, this Ohana palette just screams summer. Like, when I think of a vacay palette, I think of something like this. And again, we are going to be doing, like, two different eye looks, because I want to use as many colors as possible. But the first one I want to go in with is this matte, kind of almost, like, mustardy marigold kind of shade. Now, I don't know if I said it, but it's called Family. Okay, that is a really pretty color. Again, it's kind of almost like a sunshine, buttery kind of yellow. It's a little bit brighter on the eye than it looks in the pan, which I like a little bit more. But wow, like, the pigment is really nice right away. I'm also going to take just like a little bit more and round out around the outer edge. And really just kind of like blur and diffuse it all. Now, one of the shades I'm very curious about in this palette is this kind of like corally pinky kind of color called Lilo. I'm just taking it on this Morphe M433. But why I'm curious is because a lot of like reds and corals, they can really overpower a look. And I'm curious to see how the pigment is. But like right off, there's so much pigment to this shade. Like, this is only one dip. And it's also not like overpowering the yellow either, but it's also giving me a very good blend at the same time. So let's go in with a second layer. Oh yeah. Like, the first layer, she's cute, but that second layer just really added that like little pop. I'm also, again, rounding out that outer edge. So now we're gonna start with the other eye, and I wanna go in with this like periwinkle jean blue kind of shade, and it's called 626. This one feels really soft in the pan, but I'm just going in with a different Anastasia 825. And again, I pop it in the crease and then blend it outwards. And, ooh, this is actually applying a little bit deeper than I thought it was going to. I'm just going to take a little bit more on my brush. Like, this one has pigment, but it's, like, one of those kinds of shades that really, like, grabs onto my eye primer. So I'm feeling like I have to go in with more pigment because of it. I feel like I just need to maybe, like, press it down and then kind of, like, buff it out. Just because, again, it's, like, really sticking. Like, I'm not used to my, like, matte shades sticking like this. And again, it's not giving me, like, a harsh line or anything. It's just, like, really, like, gripping on. As a side note, it's really hard to find this shade of blue with a really nice formula. Because a lot of times it almost acts like a pastel where it's very, like, dusty on the eye. So it, like, grabs on really funny and very uneven. Not that it's, like, dusty in the air. But this one, oh, like, it is so nice. Now, I don't know if I'm gonna like the depth on this, but you know what? I need to use it. And that is this really pretty cobalt blue called Evil Koala. Ooh, I barely tap my brush. Like, it looks so pigmented on the brush. Okay, I have high hopes for this now. But let's see what happens. Because again, like, these kinds of blues, nightmare. They can be terrible. Okay, but so far, this is looking really pretty. To me, though, they are a little bit similar with the depth on the first layer. So we're gonna build it up. We're gonna see what happens. Ooh. Oh yeah, now that is what I'm talking about. Like, seriously, with this palette, Wet n Wild is not playing with the pigment. Like, every time I apply another shade, I get more and more impressed by this palette. Because, I mean, it is so nice. I feel like I would need both of these shades in the same palette. Not that I don't like the formula, it's just like they're very similar on the eye in a way. Like, again, the one that we just used, the Evil Koala shade, it is a little bit brighter, whereas the 626 shade's a little bit more, like, muted. Since these blues are so similar, what I want to do is go in with this Pudge shade, which is almost, I don't know, it's like a lighter tan, almost like bone kind of shade. It's not light enough to be a bone, but it's also not, like, a true tan either. And this one's kind of like one of those mattes that has shimmer in it. But I'm going to be going in with this shader brush. This one's from Anastasia, it's an A24. And I'm just going to soften up this edge in hopes to kind of lighten it too, so we can kind of match the vibe of the yellow. You know, with this shade almost having like a little hint of yellow to it, it's kind of giving us like this tiny touch of green. I don't know if you can see it, looks really pretty. So off camera, I just cut my crease and I also fluffed that deeper shade onto the lid as well, just a little bit to help with blending. But on this eye, like the warm tone side, I wanna go in with this kind of like gold shade called Island Time. Now I'm gonna go in with this dry, you know, just to see what we're working with. And so far, I wouldn't say it's like a really like glittery kind of shimmer. Again, this one's really grabbing onto my eye primer. Yeah, this one's definitely more of like a wet sheen. It's not like super crazy glittery either, or like sparkly. It's a little soft. Let's see if applying that with my fingers better. Yeah, honestly, like that made the world of difference. Normally, I like these brushes to apply shimmer, but sometimes like finger just works way better. Okay, when I saw the name of this shade though, so on the blue side, we're gonna go in with this one. It's called Aloha Beaches. That is so cute. I know I sound really obnoxious right there, but like, I was like, did I hear that right? And I was like, yup. But this shade, in my opinion, is applying a lot more smooth. It seemed like when I just popped it down. I kind of hope that it plays a little bit more of like a green gold kind of vibe. Yeah, like it almost has like this brightness to it. I do think it looks more like a limey green because I have a little bit of a light blue underneath of it. So I think it's kind of mixing with that. I guess I wouldn't say mixing, but with it on top of that, I think it just pulls more green. But these are definitely not like really like in your face sparkly shimmers. I'll warn you too, this Aloha Beaches shade is giving me a ton of fallout. So definitely do your eyes first with this shade as well as with the blues. The blues had a little bit of fallout, especially that, the deeper one that we used, but not like this shimmer. Okay, but this sponge and scrub set is so cute. I mean, look at how adorable that is. I also really like the colors. Now, if you're not familiar with like a scrubber, it kind of is like this silicone, kind of like flexible plastic kind of situation with some like grippies. I don't know how to explain it. It has like some texture. So what you use this for is, you know, to help scrub like your sponge when you're cleaning it or your makeup brushes. And it helps to kind of like break down the product and all of that. And you can also use this to store your sponge when it's drying from, you know, cleaning it and whatnot, because it does sit flat. So I'm just going to go in with my foundation because I'm curious to see how much product this sponge absorbs, if it absorbs any. And I did dampen it underneath my sink. And I also washed it as well. But ooh, it does absorb a little bit, but not that much. You know, it really reminds me of the Care Bear collection from Wet n Wild. You know that like 5-pack of sponges? This one's very similar to those. And as like a sponge, it is pretty squishy. Like it's not like super crazy squishy, and it's also not like hard either. It's like the good amount of squish. But so far, I think it's blending this out really nice. And you can see like on the print itself, it does have stitch in there. And you can see it's really not absorbing much. Which is nice, because that's my biggest problem with sponges, is that they absorb way too much product, so it's kind of like a waste. Let's see how it applies other products, or I guess blends them out. So I'm just blending out my cream contour. Ooh! Yeah, like, it's actually really nice. Again, I really like how it's like hugging the cheek, like the butt of it. Like, this is a really good size for a sponge, and if you're like me, I have really small hands, and it's not like super huge. And now let's go in with the Hoola Honey Face Palette. And I'll say, like, I like stuff like this, but I also don't at the same time because for me personally, being so fair, I'm not going to be able to wear, you know, all of the shades in here. I might be able to wear this highlight. I'm not too sure. And let's see what this bronzer looks like. Ooh, actually, I think I might be able to wear this. Also, these are more like a cool tone bronze, it seems. They don't seem, like, super crazy, like, warm, which I really like because I feel like a lot of bronzers are just way too, like, Oompa Loompa-y. And they don't have individual names. They're just like a face palette. And then here is the deeper shade. It seems like they're a little bit more of like a medium pigmentation, which I like a lot more personally because then you can build it up if you want to. It's a little bit easier to blend as well. And then here is the lighter highlight. And then where's the deeper one? There it is. And then here's the lighter highlight. And then the deeper one. Ooh, they look super sparkly. Now my swatches are a little bit wonky, but this is what they look like. My camera is acting up, so we're gonna do it on this cheek. But, oh my gosh, like, I absolutely love this shade. Again, at first I didn't think I was gonna be able to wear it because in the pan, it looks way too dark for me. Like, I'm like, that's not gonna work. Like, it definitely looks like a light medium type of skin tone one, but since it's more on the buildable side, I feel like it actually works for me. And also, it really reminds me of Benefit's Hoola Light, if you've ever used that one. And formula-wise, it is not, like, powdery in the pan. It's not, like, super, like, dusty, if you know what I mean. Like, there's not, like, a lot of kickback when you dip your brush in. But I mean, like, look at this. And it's blending in so nice, too. Like, it's not giving me, like, helmet head, nothing. I am, like, literally shocked by this. Like, I didn't think it was gonna work for me, but this might be, like, my favorite item out of everything so far. Like, I love the eyeshadow palette, but man, like, it's hard for me to find a good bronzer, and this one's really nice. So for the lower lash line, I'm just gonna match what we did in the crease underneath. So I'm just gonna start with this corally color. And honestly, I'm just gonna use the same brush each time because, I mean, why dirty more than you have to? I'm just gonna pop it right under. Ooh, it caught my lash. And then now for the blue side, and again, you want to start with the deepest shade first. It also helps if you use like a smaller brush to really get all up in there. And then afterwards, I go in with the lighter one. So for the inner corner, I'm just going to do again the same thing. I'm just going to use what we used on the lid right here down, because otherwise I don't think it's going to match. Because there's not like an icy like white gold in this palette that would work with both sides. So I think this is the best play. And again, I'm just using my brush dry. And then now for the green side. Now we have liner lashes to try out, which I am really excited about these both, because again, I have really stubby lashes, and if I can find like a Holy Grail mascara, I am all about it. And also, I like pencil liners, especially in the waterline. And again, the packaging, it is a vibe. Like, it definitely has like that vacay look to it. I'm first just gonna tight line my waterline using the black one. And it's actually a really small little liner too. I don't know if you can see it. Like, it's a lot smaller than a traditional like pencil. Like, this one is one of my favorites, and this is the Urban Decay 24/7. And you can see like the tip is super, super tiny. Ooh, this blue is so pretty. Oh yeah, that is very bright. It's not something I would normally pop in my waterline, but you know what? I want to use everything as much as I can. But you can see it is really bright and very pigmented. And again, like, this is a very smooth eyeliner. I'll show you what I mean. You see what I'm talking about? Like, you don't really need a lot of pressure with it, but it's also not so creamy like you're gonna burn through it fast. I'll show you the matte black one as well. Oop. Put it on its side. But you see, it's like very inky and smooth. Now to give this mascara the true test, we have to use it on the lower lashes because Bi's lower lashes suck. Like, I'm always somebody, I always wear falsies. So it's not like the truest test to use it on the upper lashes, but the lower lashes, they flake easier for me. You know, a lot of mascaras, they don't always make them look good. And wand-wise, this one is kind of like a little bit of an hourglass. And it's more of like a plastic bristle kind of vibe. Okay. Like, right off the bat, it's really easy to get the lower lashes because of the shape. And it's like the perfect size for a mascara wand, too. It's not like those big, big boy ones. Because I feel like sometimes that one's really hard to use on the lower lashes. And I'm somebody, I don't like to use two mascaras. I don't like to have one for the upper lashes and one for the bottom. I would like just, you know, one mascara to run through. So far, it's really cute. Again, I wouldn't say it's like my new favorite mascara, but it definitely works. And with it having those plastic bristles, it can be kind of tricky to get the lower lashes without like smudging it. It's not like super crazy volumizing, and it's not like lengthening. It's like right in the middle. Now, I don't know if I've ever seen something like this from Wet n Wild before, but this is a wet lip oil gloss. So I'm assuming it's in between a lip oil and a lip gloss. I'm not 100% sure. But I do want to say, though, like, the packaging is really nice on these. I don't know if you can see, but each of the lip gloss shades have a different stitch on them. And also, like, it's not a sticker, like, it's printed onto the tube. But the first one we have is, like, the mauve one, and this one's called Got the Scoop, and it has him with a little ice cream stack. Oh, like, it is so cute. And scent-wise, not a fan. Kind of smells like bubblegum. And I'm just, honestly, I'm just not a bubblegum kind of fan. But I'd say it's like a medium pigmentation, I would say. Yeah. Like, it has a good amount of pigment, but it's not like completely opaque. Next we have the red one, and this one's called Let's Rock, and he's playing a ukulele, I believe. Nope, it's a guitar actually. And this one smells almost like cherry, strawberry, something along those lines. It's like super sweet. Ooh. Like, it's almost more of like a hot pink reddish kind of shade. Like, it's not like a full-on red. It has a little bit of like a hot pink kind of vibe. And then the last one we have is like an iridescent blue. This is the one that really is catching my eye. And it's called Surfs Up. And of course, he has a surfboard. And this one, I don't know, it almost smells like blueberry to me. Or like a raspberry. Just has like a berry, like Jolly Rancher kind of vibe. And I don't know, I don't see like the blue sparkles in it, but we will see if we can see them on the lip. Now, I am somebody, I use a lot of lip oils, and to me, this doesn't really feel like a traditional lip oil. Like, it's not that it's uncomfortable, it's just not as like oily as a lip oil. Like, it definitely feels more like a traditional, like, gel-like lip gloss. And again, it is very juicy. I would also say it's more of like a hydrating gloss as well. Because it kind of has like this lip mask almost feel to it. For a lip gloss though, it is a little bit heavy on the lip. And also, it does have like this tingle to it. I don't know if it's plumping, like it doesn't say plumping on the packaging, but it kind of has like that tingly, minty kind of feel. And you can see like a little hint of like a bluish purple iridescent, but it's definitely not like over the top. Now this highlighter might be a little bit too deep for me, but I need to try it anyway, so I'm gonna go in the lightest shade on this brush from Anastasia. And I have a feeling it's gonna be really bright and popping, because I mean, Wet n Wild's known for that with their highlights. Oh yeah. Oh, this is so pretty. It does have like a little bit of a glittery glow to it. It's not like full on glitter, but if you don't like glitter in your highlights, you might not like this one. But I mean, oh yeah. It's so pretty, especially next to that bronzer. I really like the two together. So we're gonna top off the look using the Hydrating Setting Mist, and let's see how the sprayer is. It's very similar to the Care Bears one, if you've tried those. It kinda shoots out a little bit. I wish it was a little bit finer. Oh yeah, it's definitely very hydrating. You can see it's giving my skin just a little bit of glow. Oh yeah. This is like perfect for summer. And scent-wise, it kind of has like a beachy scent to it. It's not like coconutty or like sunscreen-ish. It just, I don't know, it just screams beach to me for some reason. Like when you think of a beach scent, it kind of smells like that. Now with this collection, there are two kind of more like body care kind of items. And this first one right here is Life's a Beach. It's an exfoliating multi-scrub? Multi-scrub. I don't know why I said it, it's so weird. But mine kind of like busted in the package. I don't know if you can see, but there's like an oily like residue over this and like everything else in the box. So I'm gonna go clean this up and then we'll talk about it. And then we also have this Soaking Up Rays Body Illuminizer. And it's in a sprayer just like the setting spray. Okay, but the scrub comes with this little scooper that looks like one of those ones that you make like sandcastles with. And yeah, like this did kind of bust. I think what happened is it like untwisted during packaging, maybe got like hot and cold or something along those lines. But let's see how the texture is. I've never tried something like this from Wet n Wild. I don't know if they have something like this in their normal line. Ooh, she's thick. Oh, I almost got my nose right there. Yeah, it definitely has like a summery kind of vibe to it. And grit-wise, like, it's a little sticky, which I like personally. And it feels a little bit heavy. And grit, oh yeah, like this is right up what I want. Like, it is gritty, but not too gritty, because I have sensitive skin. And it's also not, like, too oily. Like, it's, like, literally perfection with the feeling of it. Now, I am going to try this on my legs. I have really dry skin on my legs, and I'll let you guys know how it works. And then the last item that we have is the Soaking Up Body Illuminizer. And I'm just somebody, like, I'm not, like, fully into stuff like this. Oh, I thought it was a spray bottle, but it's actually a pump. Oop. You gotta prime it. But it's kind of like, oh god, I kind of spray it everywhere. That even got in my mouth, ugh. But, like, yeah, I don't, like, the pump is kind of a little, I don't know, stuck. And then let's see how it looks. It's kind of like a body oil, but it's not, like, super, like, oily. Which I like, because I don't like to feel greasy. Like, this one's definitely not greasy. Honestly, not a whole lot's going on with this. Like, it's just like a body oil to me. Like, there's not really like any shine or like sparkle to it. And I don't feel like it's giving me like a wet sheen either. To me, this just doesn't do a whole lot. And keep in mind, I shook it first for like 20 seconds. Let's shake it more and see if that makes it better. I don't know. Like, I'm going in with the shaking. It's like a shake. Wait. I don't want it to spray. Oh, yeah. Like, it gets everywhere. If you're not careful. Let's see if it blends out better. Or has more sparkle. Yeah, like, I just don't see, like, a shine to it. Like, again, it is an oil-based, so it's gonna have, like, a little bit. Because I have really bright lights in here, but I just don't see, like, the sparkle in it. I am so obsessed with this collection. Like, seriously, it is so amazing. And I really like the look that we got with it today, too. It kind of has, like, this tropical kind of vibe to it, which I feel really fits the vacay theme that we have going on with this one. Now, I will say, overall, I actually really enjoy everything that we've tried today. The only thing I'm a little bit meh about is that body luminizer. Again, it ain't bad. It's just not a well. Like, if I were to purchase this, I'd be like, where's the sparkle? But if you're looking for just, like, a body oil that feels really nice, it is really good. It's just, I'm looking for, like, a wow factor if I were to use something like this, because, again, it's not something I would typically reach for. So take my opinion with a grain of salt. The other thing I'm kind of a little bit meh about is the mascara. Again, it ain't a bad mascara. It's just, it's not a wow. Like, it works, it's just, it's not gonna do more than, like, a basic mascara would. Now, if you were to ask me what I would recommend if you were to only get one item out of this collection, I would say either the eyeshadow palette or the face palette, depending on what kind of person you are. And the reason I'm saying both is because if you already have a lot of eyeshadow palettes, get the face palette. Because, again, like, the formula of these, oh my gosh. Like, the bronzer in here, it's so buttery and smooth. It literally acts like all of my high-end bronzers. And the highlighter in here is super extra blinding without having like that really glittery vibe to it. The only thing is why I am a little eh about this palette is because you're not going to be able to use every shade in here depending on your skin tone. Like for me, I'm only able to use two shades, so the other two are like something I'm not going to reach for. And I know somebody's going to say, well, you could use them as eyeshadow, but I already have a lot of neutral eyeshadow palettes, so it's not something I'm going to reach for, you know, to use this only for like eyeshadow. You know what I mean? I'm just going to use my eyeshadow palettes. So, you know, just kind of keep that in mind. But if you're somebody that likes eyeshadow a little bit more, if you're looking for, you know, more eyeshadow palettes in general that have some bright colors, this one is beautiful. Again, very bright, very fun. And again, if you're a beginner, this one is not hard to work with. Even the bright blues in here, which I know can be a little bit tricky, but I think this palette is just really beautiful and definitely worth checking out. But yeah, so in the comments down below, let me know what you think about this collection, and also let me know if you're going to be picking up anything from it and what you're going to get if you decide to do so. And also, if you've tried anything, let me know what you think about it. But before you go though, if you haven't already, make sure you hit the subscribe button down below and also give this video a like. And if you'd like to check me out over on Instagram or TikTok, it's at Breyonna Fay as well. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye!